Something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined.
I thought I saw, and when we touched, she didn't shudder at my paw. No, this can't be, I'll just ignore her. But then she never looked at me that way before. Why, when she smiles at me, I get all choked up. I can't breathe, and my heart starts pounding.
Good!
That's good.
Excellent!
I've never felt this way about anyone before. I want to give her something.
Oh, they're the usual things. Flowers, chocolates, promises you don't intend to keep.
No, this is no ordinary girl. You want to get her something special. Something that sparks her interest. Something...
What? Are you sure?
Say something about the dress.
It's pink.
A compliment!
Oh. That's a nice dress.
Thank you.
Belle, there's something I want to show you.
Master! Get the girl!
But first, close your eyes, because it's a surprise.
May I open them?
Almost. It's yours.
If it is to be, it will be very soon now.
Come along, son.
Knowing not that this was indeed the legendary sword called Excalibur, Arthur tried to pull it from the stone. He tried once, to no avail. He tried a second time, but still he could not pull it out. Then, for the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword.
Hold on, Shephard! He's the king!
Wait and see.
Oh, I never knew books could do this.
Do what?
Take me away from this place. Help me forget for a little while.
Forget?
Who? No, what I am.
We have something in common, you know.
What?
In the town where I come from, people think I'm odd.
You?
So I know how it feels to be different. And I know how lonely that can be. For the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword, and there arose from the people a great shout. Arthur is king.
Told you so.